My name is Dili Tarua.
That's my name.
And I'm from Papua New Guinea.
And I'm George Pana. I'm her husband and also from Papua New Guinea.
I was diagnosed with diabetes type 2 in 1994 when I was studying in Australia.
Yes.
And then from then on I was always having, I've been diabetic. And then last year, July, I was diagnosed with chronic kidney failure.
There's been some changes, so we were now made to depend more on the dialysis. So it was in our case, it was more like a trial and error. So when they tried dialysis and it worked, or she started to feel better, they confirmed that maybe, you know, that was the way to go for us. So dialysis was the big change in our life. You know, we had to look at going for dialysis once a week. Staying on dialysis for 4 hours a day when you're in there, so that's completely changed the picture for us. We did some research on food and the diet and what type of foods to avoid and to keep out of the diet. So that was the change that we had to go through. But we felt that even with those changes, we still needed to get something. A different alternative of treatment, as well as a proper diet plan. And so that helped us to make the decision to come out and look for the alternative. The main thing that made our decision to come to Thailand was the information, the clarity of the information that made us understood very clearly what we were getting ourselves into. We found out a bit about China and what they were doing with kidney diseases, and in terms of, in the process of searching, and also when we talked to our doctor at home, he mentioned stem cells, but more from China, and then so we started looking or searching for stem cells anywhere else apart from China, mainly because of the communication difficulties we were having with China. So the first point of contact we did was with China, so we were exchanging notes with them, and then we came across the Regeneration Center of Thailand, and then filled in the forms, send the information in. Then we got the response from Jamie, and I think the difference was that we could clearly tell what you know, the information Jamie was giving us was very something that we could follow.
Yes.
So that kind of raised our confidence in the information that was being provided. So we continued to exchange emails whilst continuing with the China one.
Yes.
And then we weighed both of them up, and then we believed that, you know, if maybe we should look at Thailand as a, you know, a different approach, because everyone in PNG was going to China, Philippines. And Singapore, I think. But Thailand was for us was the first. Because of the experience we've had, we have had no negative experience since we arrived in Thailand. From the, you know, the pick up at the airport to the hotel, the pick up from the hotel to the clinic, and meeting the doctors, nothing negative at all. So we would strongly recommend not only stem cell regeneration, but also to do with the Regeneration Center of Thailand, because we have gone through and experienced this, you know, it's very good outcome for us, we believe. And so we would strongly say, you know, ask them to also look at Thailand and look at Regeneration Center. That Friday was the first stem cell transfusion itself. But before then, they lead up with B-peptide and growth factor injections just to prepare the body for receiving the stem cells.
I think it's still early days yet, but I'm beginning to feel like there's not much swelling on my feet.
Mm-hmm.
And tightness sickness, I still get a bit tired, but mm-hmm. not as much as before. But yeah, I feel hungry more often now, yeah.
I think that we also want to share was yes. the last blood results we got after dialysis, and the doctors we went through with them yesterday.
Yes.
Miss Pinsu, the clinic manager, had goosebumps when she looked at the results, because
it's better.
The first after dialysis on the 3rd of April,
mm-hmm.
The creatinine dropped to 6.4, and the BUN, which was the blood urea and
yes.
nitrogen, that dropped to about 47.
Wow.
And then before dialysis, just the Friday or Thursday,
yes.
or Wednesday,
yes.
Again, that was normal, that it went back up. And then after dialysis, so the comparison was the after dialysis on the 3rd and
yes.
after dialysis just last week. The creatinine dropped from 6.4 to 5.4, so by 1 point. And the BUN dropped from 47 to 28. Okay. Also, the dialysis whilst here
yes.
Was arranged by the clinic, and
yes.
you know that was again another positive. We did not we were not left on our own to
yes.
look
arranged.
For
yes.
Dialysis, because
yes.
it was not part of the,
yes.
the original plan, but and it was just close proximity, and the people at the B&H hospital also very very nice, you know, how they took us in, ask questions, you know, and then make sure that we were comfortable, and it's just amazing, you know, the experiences we had here. We will continue to speak highly of when we get back home.
Kukun Krab.